and welcome to my channel. Today I have a new makeup tutorial for you and I wanted to go for something, I don't know, quite wearable yet not completely wearable. I mean, you could leave out the dots if you wanted to be more wearable, I suppose. But anyway, I just wanted to do something with neutral colors, which is rather a rare thing for me, like no really bright shades and all. And yeah, this is how it turned out, so let's get started. As usual, just priming my eyes first with concealer and powder. Now I'm going to use the Maybelline Quarter 2 in Crayon Rose. Some of you might remember I used to use this all the time as a primer on top of the powder and concealer. And I haven't done so in ages, so I just want to try it out again to see if I enjoy it more than not doing it. The moment the primer is on there, you can probably also usually see some hairs that you don't want to be there. Okay, about the primer, just a little note. I did dab it on with the brush instead of dragging it on just because, you know, I didn't want to disturb anything beneath it, but it does go perfectly smooth that way, surprisingly. Yeah, other than that, for the eyeshadows, I think I said it pretty much any tutorial, but you can use whatever you want, whatever you have, whatever you prefer using. I'm just going to use what I have and what I at this moment prefer. So yeah, I'm going to use the Huda Beauty Warm Brown Obsessions Palette for most of the colors. And I'm also going to use these two shades by Kiko. This one because the palest matte shade in the palette is actually too dark to use as an eyebrow highlighter for me. And this one because it's the best black eyeshadow that I've ever used. It's the High Pigment in 15. This never gave me fallout. This is just really, really, really good. It's very intensely black as well. It's blendable. I absolutely adore it. Now the first thing I'm doing here is just applying this shade, as you can see. Sort of as a transition shade, and yeah, this is just going to make sure that everything else blends nicely. I'm really going to focus on the crease first, and the rest of the eyelid is just going to have to wait until, you know, I'm done with the crease. And I'm going to move on to a slightly darker shade, and by the way, at this point you don't need to worry yet about the cat eye too much. I try to keep it sort of tidy, but I'm still going to go for concealer and foundation and stuff like that later. I'm keeping this far more focus in really the outer part of the crease and then just slightly blending it inwards. I'm now applying a more purple-ish shade. I don't want to go straight up to black just because I don't want to screw things up at this point. So I'm just keeping it safe, starting with this first and blending it out. This will make the entire look more smooth as well. Just doing this with a pencil brush, you have more control. And now on to the scariest part, the black eyeshadow. I'm going to use a very, very tiny brush for this and I am going to focus on the wing already at this part. Mostly because putting concealer over black eyeshadow is rather difficult. I would prefer to put down the lines first, just so I know I have it symmetrical. This type of packaging, I always struggle with it. Okay, now that we finally left the box open, I'm going to highlight my brow bone. And then just to give a fun twist to it, I'm going to use this shade by Catrice, this liquid metal, in the shade Daily Dose of Rose, just to put some dots down. Secretly, I'm just doing this first because I haven't figured out what I want to put on my eyelid yet. One trick, don't actually open your eyes too widely until this stuff is dry, otherwise it will smudge. But other than that, I'm going to use Moonflower and Midnight Cowboy, both by Urban Decay, on my eyelids. I'm going to use Moonflower more as a transition shade between the pale part and the dark part. For my eyelashes, I'm first going to coat them in just a little bit of mascara just to get them a little bit more clean. They're already black because I tinted both my eyelashes and eyebrows yesterday. You could just go for mascara alone, of course, with this look, as always. But I'm going to use the Ardell Wispies because I bought them yesterday and I really want to try them out. By the way, I really like the packaging because you can actually open and close it, like it actually closes back up, which is very nice just for storing them. Okay, I gotta say, I really, really like these eyelashes. As you can see, like, this eye is just normal. This eye is just a lot more hairy. I really like these. They're definitely more subtle than the Exo Beauty ones I always love to use. But yeah, I'm glad I bought them. Also, they are very comfortable to wear. And what I like about them is that they have a clear lash band, which means that they look more natural. So you can also use them without using eyeliner, which is a plus because all my Exo Beauty ones have a dark lash band. So yeah, I always feel sort of compelled to do eyeliner when I wear those, but these I can wear without liner. By the way, you know, all those really old eyelashes that I used to use on my channel, you know, the I don't know where they're from. They might be eBay, they might be Ardell, I really don't know. Yeah, I still have those. I know I should really toss them because I haven't used them in a year. They're really like broken up, old, ancient, decaying. But I just can't help it. I always fear that if I throw them away, that I'm going to miss them. Is anyone else like that? I can't be the only one. Okay, I was on the fence for moments about which primer to use, but I'm going to go for the Ordinary High Adherence Silicone Primer for the simple reason that I haven't used it in ages. No particular reason for that, by the way. Like, I don't know, I use the Catrice Foundation a lot, so I tend to also use the Catrice Primer. However, this one is also very, very nice. It does make my skin very nice and smooth. By the way, I was planning on wearing earrings with this look because these don't just fit so nicely with it. But yeah, because these are still like healing, I'm still giving them, you know, enough time to get used to the new sizey stretches. So I can't wear silicone plugs in them yet, tunnels. And with metal, this just doesn't stick, obviously, unfortunately. So yeah, just imagine I'm wearing earrings with it. For foundation, I'm going to use the L'Oreal True Match in the shade 3.N. That took me way too much effort to read. Beige cream, which is slightly paler than the other L'Oreal foundation, but slightly darker than my Catrice one, so I think it's going to be perfect for my fake tan. Just applying it with a beauty blender, and as you can see, it is quite, I don't want to say orange because it sounds negative, and I do actually very much like the shade on me. However, if you have a very cool skin tone, I think this may be too warm toned for you, so do keep that in mind. But if you have a warm skin tone, or neutral to warm like me, then this will probably be perfect. Okay, perfect match. For concealer, I'm going to use the Catrice one, this time in a light beige. This point, I'm also taking care to sharpen up the wing. You could use a brush for this, that's probably easier than using a egg-shaped thing, but yeah, I'm already holding the beauty blender and I'm sort of lazy, so yeah, I'm just using this and it works. Then I'm quickly going to bake. I'm keeping my eyebrows simple, by the way. I'm just applying a little bit of brow gel, just combed the, you know, just powder out of it with a spoolie. I'm applying brow gel, just an old one by Catrice, and then I'm going to use a NYX brow pomade just to fill in the gaps. The more recent I've actually tinted my eyebrows, the easier they are to fill in. Anyway, I'm now going to just blend out the powder. The Catrice California and the Box Palette seems to have the exact right sort of color scheme for this look. So I'm going to use these two shades, the contour shade, bronze and that sort of stuff. I'm also going to use the blush. Not sure yet about the highlighter, we'll know when we get there. Starting out with a darker shade, and I'm just moving on to the paler shade. just decided to indeed go for the highlighter from this palette. Okay, just going to finish up my under eye area now, and yeah, this time I didn't forget, by the way, you can tell, because I haven't applied setting spray yet. Last time I actually completely forgot to do my under eye. But anyway, I'm going to go back to do the beauty palette for a moment, and I like to keep this stuff simple, so I'm just going to use a fluffy brush, a stubby brush, and a tiny brush. First the transition shade, I'm just going to put that until like 3/4. Then the darker shade, I'm going to put that until about 1/3. Then the purplish shade, I can't think of a measurement, but you know, just very, very, very much only in the outer corner. Just blending it out. Then on the mini brush, the black shade, and that's just going to go beneath the outer lashes. And blending that as well. Okay, I want the outer edge to be a little bit more sparkly, so I'm going to use the highlighter for that that I used earlier. And I really rubbed off this brush really, really well to get all the black out. On the waterline, I'm going to put a Smart Color Pencil by Kiko in the shade 02. And then some Sexy Pulp Eater shade to finish off the lashes. Then, time for some setting spray. I'm going to use the NYX Matte Finish today. It's almost empty, and I think I'm actually going to repurchase this when it's actually empty. I'll throw it in a, empty video once that time hits, and I'll tell you if I buy a new one or not. I think I will, because I really, really love this. You do have to spray quite a lot to cover your entire face, but it does dry matte, and it just feels very, very nice. Then time for the lips. I'm actually going to combine two that I've had for ages. I smeared mascara in my hair anyway. I'm going to use these two Sleek Matte Me Lip Creams in Fandango Purple and Birthday Toot. Okay, I gotta say, I love the coverage and the colors and just overall quality of this stuff considering the low price. However, I really don't like the stiff applicators. I can work with them, but using them always takes a little bit more time than it would with a more flexible one. With the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of makeup videos, nail art videos, piercing videos, chatty videos, and whatever else I can think of. Below the video, as always, you can find the full list of all the products I've used on my face today, just in case I forgot to mention something or if it went too quick, you can just find the full name down there. Also, you can find all my social media accounts and names down there. I'm mostly active on Instagram. I always share it there whenever I upload a new video onto my YouTube channel, so I'd really love it if you'd want to follow me there. Other than that, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!